Water Project Watch, this is Serbi. Now, today we have some news. Look like it could be some 160 news. This is major. This is absolutely major. Gleaner broke a story. When we see them post that Vaas gets back US visitors visa with rare waiver. And them even post the visa itself. Now, we are going to say, boy, Serbi, you know, say, you're bad man scam and them thing, but you're really so desperate that you're broken out Daryl Vaas' house and taking visa and post it. No, I clean up my seat, you know. But what about it? Because after all, this man is a serving politician in the current government, right, and the people of Jamaica, who already have a whole heap of questions. Something like this happened, what do you think we are going to do? Right, just ignore it, just pretend like when you see, right, a part of the visa way, you know, extremely spooky. A part of the visa way, Daryl Vaas, right, me understand, so him say him now, you know, I give no comment on it, but me don't know what kind of country a politician can have something like this on a visa and I'm gonna, you know, just choose finna talk about it. This I forget addressed. Right. What me I talk about? We want to know, look on the screen. Right. This is the actual visa. Right. Now, you see the part where say 212 d 3a waiver, right, of 212 a 2c 1 granted. At that part, that is spooky part. Why is it spooky? Right. I'm telling you, because Glenn, I even talked to an expert in the whole immigration thing. But in case you wonder, what the 212 a 2c 1 mean? Right. It talk about control diet coke smugglers, or it could be herbs too. Basically, you know, Jamaican say joggies. They talk about joggies. This is a direct quote. It refers to a visitor who the consular office or the US Attorney General knows or has reason to believe is or has been an illicit trafficker. Let me say that again. 212A2C1, right, refers to a visitor who the consular office or the US Attorney General, right, not Sir P, the local YouTuber, to make up things, a bad mind scammer, and fight against artists. The US Attorney General knows or has reason to believe is or has been an illicit trafficker in any controlled substance or in any listed chemical, or is or has been a knowing aider, abettor, assister, conspirator, or colluder with others in the illicit trafficking in any such controlled or listed substance or chemical, or endeavor to do so. That makes sense, don't it, right? So when you see, it's a waiver of that. That means Daryl Vaas lost his visa because Uncle Sam designated him, right, as one of them individuals. I wonder if now listen to me. People of Jamaica, the United States government have reasons to believe Sir Daryl Vaas, right, a move, right, quote unquote, right, controlled substance. The US government, remember, not the PIA, right, who just bad mind people for them things, right, but the US government with all them resources, right, with all them information, who pick up how much money from Jamaica over the years, how much done, right, how much smugglers carry them to America and give them some small sentence, collect how much intel and then sit down on the intel, have reason to believe that Daryl Vaas and move products. I'm not talking about iPhone and watch. The Gleaner speak to an immigration attorney named Wayne Golding. You hear the man say? Open and listen, you know. Because them things they just fly through one ear and gone through the other. You must say that a person can be deemed inadmissible to the US because of a number of things, right? Alright, he goes on to state. Golding said the section under which a waiver was granted applies when there may be the belief that there was some diet coke offense or herbs offense. Let's be realistic, either diet coke or herbs are both of them. I don't look around on a random chemical, I don't like say my tricell, the grandma's own acid. He noted that the US Attorney General can grant a waiver to anyone who falls or is suspected to fall in that category. This is a direct quote. It is unclear what they are saying he is believed to have done, but that's the clause under which they granted the waiver. They are saying you are inadmissible under that category but we're granting you a waiver. Remember that, Youngfield. So Uncle Sam has said, right, when it comes on, right, to the smuggling thing, right, we believe, say, at this year involved, now, but we're going to give you a waiver to travel same way. Even though Uncle Sam can designate this to you and take away your visa, he can give you a different type of visa, which is what Daryl Vaz now has. Right, the B1, B2 that Daryl Vaz has. Why him get it? Well, Daryl Vaz is going to be doing a delegation in the US for information and communications technology and cyber security consultations. So he might go to Uncle Sam's place again, right, next month for information and communications technology and cyber security consultations. So Daryl Vaz, I go to America, go do this. And Uncle Sam say, all right, see the B1, B2 visa. So we give you a waiver pan the 21 A2 C1. That makes sense to you? More than understand them, more even the man will never go to school if you understand it. The original visa gets snatched, right, because Uncle Sam believes Daryl Vaz, right, a smuggle something. But no, the man said, we are getting a waiver from that. Right, we are going to get this type of visa for 1 year. In other words, we still feel, say, you're mixed up in the things, but you can't come here like a conference. We still feel, say, you're smuggling and everything, but right, since next month you have come for this and that. Forward, see one next week, see one little visa, yeah. 1 year, yeah, I get 1 year. 1 day, get a year. Wanna see what I'm gonna go discuss? It's spooky. It's spooky. Me wanna have some kind of water commission thing go on. Because remember, even the immigration officer say, it is very rare to them get a waiver. Right, US immigration attorney Wayne Golding Senior, the man said it rare for them things are gone. Right. He said the individual, right, when them get granted the waiver, could have been flagged by the consular officers because of a relative. But guess what? So, Daryl Vaz's wife, he get flagged too. So that means that Anne-Marie Vaz lose fair visa. Right. Because she get flagged for being, obviously, Daryl Vaz's wife. He goes on to state they may have information on a family member who has committed an offense and they broad brush everyone, or they have reason to believe that you may have benefited from the crime in some way. Now, the same immigration officer mentioned a part, you see, right, and I quote, in the US, all a consular officer has to do is have reason to believe based on the information he or she has. Sometimes it can also be an accusation and they take note of it. It doesn't mean that the person is guilty of doing it. Ask yourself this question. Do you think Uncle Sam would just walk down the road one day, stop for buy one bottle of water, hear somebody stand upside him and say, yo, you know what I say? If you say there was small things, Uncle Sam say, what? Alright, but take your visa. Daryl Vaz was a sitting minister in a serving government. It was a massive decision to take away visa at the time. A massive decision. One way Uncle Sam couldn't seriously just make our father sound like willy-nilly. Just take away that yeah, man. And then, really? So, when we read up the information, it is saying that you don't need a conviction. Uncle Sam doesn't need to convict you for smuggling. So technically speaking, because you've not been in a court of law, you're innocent. But Uncle Sam have reason for belief, say, at this year, though, so them take away them things from you because the visa have literally fit them things. Them can take away them visa at any time. And remember, Philip Paul will also lose female. So when time I read up more upon this 212A2C thing, this is what we find. And you can do your own research and just search for the number them we are see, numbers and letters. The line we see underlining already. Hear what I say. Right. Let me start from the sentence above that, or the paragraph above that. This trafficking-related visa decision is usually based on information in US government databases. Let me say that again. This trafficking-related visa decision is usually based on information in US government databases, such as that of the DEA. The DEA have intel. The DEA have names. Because enough man got far and go leak. No found a favorite than them go leak. No found a favorite 90 octane them go leak. And who are 98 octane leak about? 87? You think 90 octane? Remember, leaking go up. 87 leak pan 90, 90 leak pan 116. So all the years, one of my favorite bad man them done the run off play stop shutter. Kingpin, we want to call him. All the years, I got a friend go tell him and say, Uncle Sam say, you what? We know say, your organization responsible for hundreds of Jamaicans dead. Much people get running from the community, always get burned down, but you are going to care about that, no business about Jamaicans. You know what we really care about you? You know what we really care about? The 116 we are work with. The politician that we are work with, we're gonna need some name. Because really I want 500 years to forget. I want 525 years to forget. Cause you violate. But here we can give you 120. Can give you 115. Wait up on. When your favorite Dan hear that, when your favorite Kingpin hear that. The whole of the bushings them in the pipe bust, be water leak everywhere. My name get called. See there? US government databases. Who really believes that the United States government, with all them intel, let's make a willy-nilly decision to take a man visa just so. I find those look at idle rumors. Oh, me know what happened. Them watch politics watch and I say, oh, me the US rep said Darrell, but I'm going to take a yeah, let them do. Let them do, man. This is like a movie. This is like a movie. I wonder who all them get the visa picture. I wonder if I see him there ever send it, but they never realize it. The waiver part, people are going to Google and search. Come here, I wonder how they get the visa. Because surely Gleaner, who knows, put out a visa picture, so without, you know, must get some kind of permission. It's spookified. Spookified. Now, here's the thing. I'm going to go on and read the rest. There are also many unique points relating to the finding. You see online I read? You would say, even if the visa applicant was engaged in the activity a long time ago, there is no time bar or statute of limitations on this decision. This means that even if the person was involved 20 or 30 years ago, it is irrelevant for purposes of this provision of US law. In other words, all if you stop, move the Diet Coke. All if you stop, move the Diet Coke. Clean up yourself and say, you know, you're gone legit. Here comes Uncle Sam. 20 years later, 30 years later. Oh, and up at the top, the very top, this is where I said, don't own Google and read upon 212A2C1. Because they probably can't read where I see upon the scheme, but let me read the next part out of it. Here what it say. Most importantly, the law does not require a conviction to bar a visa applicant on these grounds. If the consular officer knows or has reason to believe, well, the immigration officer said that already. Yeah. But enough reasons to leave. Because one of the things them with Jamaicans, especially Jamaican bigwigs, one of the things where them hide behind is, well, you haven't convicted me in a court of law. But Uncle Sam is well aware of the facts, eh? Not because you're convicted, that means you're innocent. That's a ridiculous thought. By that argument, Sci-Fi is an innocent man. J.J. Nakis was an innocent man. They have never been convicted in a court of law and found guilty for any murder. So Uncle Sam knows that, that reasoning is flawed. So if they have enough intel and then them research and cancer era, we don't want you to visit the country. The same thing applies to people who don't believe, right, if you say, alright, we see the video them, satellite pick up this, we have the phone call them, him a link with a group and him a make bomb come, you know what, don't come to America. Uncle Sam does say, anybody come to America because we've not found you guilty, right, of trying to blow up this, so come. And that's how Uncle Sam works. Right. If they have them intel, them say we have enough reason to believe, so you are a threat, don't come here. That's how Uncle Sam look upon them thing. All I'm saying is your favorite leader, one of your favorite leaders, was designated, right, visa get snatched under 212A2C1. And now Uncle Sam wave it, think he can go to America again for 1 year, for a little conference, on a little summit, on a little reasoning. I wonder what I'm going to reason about. Can somebody call the Water Commission, please? Can somebody put in the comment section, I want somebody to write the find the number for the National Water Commission head office, put that number in the comment section. Right? I want PIA wanting to get beer likes, make it go to the top because we need to see the Water Commission number because pipe either a leak or about to leak. We will give you 1 year for your visit. Upon cyber, interesting. But Mr. Miller really knows still, I'm just a little YouTuber. I'm mainly bad man in scammer and my thing. I'm just saying it looks spooky. It looks spooky. Man, I say it's very rare. No wave in gone. Wave? Okay, my man, I'm at airport. Remember back in the day when time I used to have to wave off people at airport? Who remember the airport them time? They used to have to walk out from the local park this and they could have looked and see the plane and say, see, and you have wave and you have wave. Then time they have no way you wave off. Enough time I rang plane, I rang somebody, but you have wave same way. And then wave the Uncle Sam game. People help me out, my son really going to school, can't really read and write, help me out. Uncle Sam I wave him off. I can't believe in the favorite leader. My uncle Sam had reason to believe. Say, yeah. Some smuggling thing are going. Real spooky. Show me a real country. Show me a country. Show me a so-called civilized nation. Show me a so-called modern nation where a current politician have that kind of designation upon him and I'm going to say no comment. Where somebody I'm going to say, you know, say even though a government, the US government, have reason to believe this and that, right? I know we are steep on visa, say get a waiver for that. Can you please tell us why you believe Uncle Sam would even think that? No comment. Excuse me? So you are a public figure, you are a politician. You quote-unquote serve the people. The people them are curious. No comment. I know why they're not for no comment. Because they've never been convicted. No. So they can just no comment away. I mean, I want to say I'm surprised, but I lie me that tell. I would be lying. Mr. Darrell Vaz. If I even the people in Portland, I need to explain what I'm going on. So. If I even the people, forget what the rest of Jamaica, remember you're Mr. Portland, at least Portland people need to know you are one. Why them leader? Have them kind of, you know what? Let me not say nothing because you know what, end of the day, Darrell Vaz can't lose Portland. Uncle Sam could have designated all he want. Uncle Sam could have waved until all his hand didn't drop off. Darrell Vaz not lose Portland. If James Robertson win back St. Thomas, after all, yeah, I feel bangarang. Nothing will come out of this. Anyway, still spooky though. Patreon squad big up himself. PIA, I don't know, no life. Vulture squad, yeah. Stay circling, bless.